हेलो क्लास 10, वी वर डूइंग चैप्टर नंबर 2, वर्क एनर्जी एंड पावर. नाउ वी हैव स्टडीड मेनी डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ एनर्जी लाइक साउंड एनर्जी, सोलर एनर्जी, लाइट एनर्जी, इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी, केमिकल एनर्जी. नाउ इन द यूनिवर्स देयर आर वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ एनर्जी, बट द टोटल सम ऑफ ऑल दीज एनर्जीज इज ऑलवेज अ कॉन्स्टेंट. So this gives us the principle of conservation of energy. According to the principle of conservation of energy, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can only be converted from one form to the other. But one condition is that the system must be an insulated system. Means neither the energy can go out of the system nor the energy, any kind of energy can in the system. So thus in an insulated system, the total energy always remains constant. Always the energy is conserved. Now, if we talk about only mechanical energy. Now, what is mechanical energy? Mechanical energy comprises of potential energy and kinetic energy. So if there is only interchange between the potential and kinetic energy, then the total mechanical energy all of a system always remains constant. It remains conserved. That means in an insulated system where there are no frictional forces, where there are no dissipation of energy, no loss of energy, kinetic energy plus potential energy is always constant. Never change. Kinetic energy, sometimes kinetic energy is more, sometimes potential energy is more, but the total sum of both the energies is always the same throughout the system. So, in this chapter, we consider two examples which will show the conservation of mechanical energy. So, the first example is a freely falling body. When a body is falling freely from the top, then the total energy along the whole path is constant. Total mechanical energy always remains the same. So suppose this is a body at point A. Initial position of the body is at point A. Let the body is of mass M. Now it is falling down. The direction of motion is downwards. It is falling towards gravity. Now it has reached the center point B and then again at the C point where it is at the ground level. So this is the starting position, this is the central position, and this is the final position of the body. Let the total height from the ground be h. The total distance of the body from the ground is h. And let the point B be situated at a distance x from the top. So what will be the distance between B and C? Obviously h minus x. So this is somewhere center point, not exactly center but somewhere in the center. Now we will see that the mechanical energy at all the three points A, B and C is same. So see, first we will find out the total mechanical energy at position A. So at position A, the initial velocity of the body is zero because it is starting from there. So what will be the kinetic energy? You know what is the formula for kinetic energy? Half mv square, where v is the velocity of the body. Here at this point the velocity is zero. So kinetic energy will also be zero. Now we will find potential energy. What is the formula for potential energy? mgh. M is the mass, g is the acceleration due to gravity, and h is the height above the ground. So at point A, what is u? mgh, because h is the height above the ground. Therefore, what will be the total mechanical energy at point A? K plus U. K is 0 and U is mgh. So, what is 0 plus mgh? mgh. So, what is the total mechanical energy at point A? mgh. H. Now the body has reached the position P. So let V1 be the velocity of the body at the point V. Now we will use the equation of motion to find the velocity at V. So we will use the equation of motion V square equals to U square plus 2AS. So here the velocity is V1, so it becomes V1 square equals to U is the initial velocity. And what was the initial velocity of the body? Zero. So 0 plus 2 and acceleration is here, acceleration due to gravity. So we will put G in place of A. And S is the distance above the ground, height above the ground. So what is there? Height above the ground. Sorry, S is the displacement of the body from point A, from the initial position. So what is the displacement of the body from the initial position? X. So it becomes V1 square equals to 0 plus 2GX. So V1 square is 2GX. Now kinetic energy is given by half MV1 square. So half M into V1 square is 2GX. 2 to cancel. So what remains? MGX. So kinetic energy at the point B is MGX. Now potential energy equals to MG into height above the ground, which is H minus X. So U equals to MG bracket H minus X. So you open the bracket, so it will become MGH minus MGX. So the total energy at point B is given by K plus U. K is MGX and U is MGH minus MGX. So MGX minus MGX cut. So what is remaining? MGX. So what is the total energy at point B? Again, MGH. Now the body has reached the ground level. So we will find the total mechanical energy at position C. Now again we will use the equation of motion V square equals to U square plus 2AS to find the velocity of the body at C. So here the velocity we have taken as V. So V square equals to 0 because initial velocity was 0 only. Plus 2GH, and the distance from the initial position is H. So V square becomes 2GH. So what is the kinetic energy of the body at point C? Half MV square. That means half M into 2GH. 2 cut, so what remains? MGH. So kinetic energy is MGH. Now we will find potential energy at this point. Because it is at ground only, so height above the ground is 0. So potential energy at point C is 0. So the total energy becomes MGH plus 0. And again you see it is MGH only. So during the free fall of a body, the total mechanical energy always remains constant. At each point it is MGH, MGH, MG. So once the body has reached some height, it gains potential energy. As the body is rising up, potential energy is increasing, kinetic energy is decreasing. At the topmost point, the kinetic energy becomes zero, potential energy becomes maximum. Then when it is descending, slowly, slowly, potential is changing into kinetic. And at the ground level, the potential becomes zero and kinetic becomes maximum. So at the topmost point, potential energy is maximum, and at the bottommost point, kinetic energy is maximum. But the total energy always remains constant. Now the second example, which shows the conservation of mechanical energy, is an oscillating simple pendulum. So this is a simple pendulum tied from a rigid support. O is the point of suspension and this is the bob. So this is the A point, is the initial position of the bob. When we take it to the extreme point, one point, and then we release it. And if we neglect the frictional forces, the simple pendulum starts oscillating. It starts moving to and so now we will show that at the three positions, like A, this is the mean position, B is the extreme position and C is the extreme position on the other side. So at the mean position and at the both the extreme position, the total mechanical energy is always constant. It is always the same. Now when we are taking the ball from A to B, it is gaining height, and at B point it has gained a height of h from the ground. So it has gained potential energy. Slowly as the ball is moving from A to B, its kinetic energy decreasing and potential energy is increasing. Thus at point B, potential energy becomes maximum and kinetic energy becomes zero at this point. So what is potential energy at this point? mgh. And because its velocity has become zero, it has come to stop. So kinetic energy becomes zero. So what is the total energy? mgh plus zero, mgh. Now again, as it is coming back, slowly slowly potential energy is changing into kinetic energy. Thus at point A, whole of the potential energy has changed into kinetic energy. That means half mv squared equals to mgh. So mm cut. So v square equals to 2gh. So at A, at position A, what is the velocity of the ball? V equals to square root of 2gh. So it will start moving with a velocity of under root 2gh. Again, as it rising up to the other position, to the other extreme point, again the kinetic energy goes on decreasing and potential energy goes on increasing. After reaching the maximum height h from the ground, potential energy becomes maximum and kinetic energy becomes zero. So at point C, again what is U? mgh. Kinetic energy zero. So what is total energy? mgh. And what was the total energy at A? Because it is at ground, height above the ground is zero, so potential energy is zero and maximum kinetic energy will gain, which is mgh. So total energy is mgh only at this point also. So at A point also total energy mgh, at B point also total energy mgh, and at C point also total energy is mgh. So this shows the conservation of mechanical energy. Of the chapter is over. Now we will do numericals of exercise 2B. So open page 41 of your book. The numericals are given there. So the first question is, two bodies of equal masses are placed at height h into h. Find the ratio of the gravitational potential energies. We know what is the formula for gravitational potential energy? U equals to mg. So when the height is h, what is u1? mgh. And then the height is 2h, so u2 becomes mg into 2h, means 2mgh. So what is the ratio between the potential energies? U1 upon u2 equals to mgh upon 2mgh. So mgh, mgh cut, and what remains? 1 upon 2. So the ratio of the potential energies at height h into h is 1 is to 2. Now question number 2, find the gravitational potential energy of 1 kilogram mass kept at a height 5 meter above the ground. What is the mass? 1 kilogram. Height is 5 meter. G is 10 meter per square second. So how will you find the gravitational potential energy? Very easy. Mg. 1 into 10 into 5. And don't forget to mention the unit. SI unit of potential energy is joule. And all units are in SI units only. Mass is in kilogram, height is in meter, and g is in meter per square second. So u becomes 50 joules. So this is the potential energy. Now third question. A box of weight 150 kg F. Here weight is given. Weight is 150 kg F. And gravitational potential energy, U is given. 14700 joule. You have to find height of the. Now since you know weight is mg, here mg is given. But it is given in kgf, so you will convert in newton by multiplying by 9.8. Because first you have to convert in newton. So multiply this, what will come? 150 into 9.8. Now you know the formula U equals to MGH. So what will be height? U upon MG. What is U? 14,700. And what is MG? 150 into 9.8. And what is the SI unit of height? Meter. So when you will solve it, you will get 10 meter. So what is the height above the ground? 10 meter. So children, now you can do these questions which are based on the formula of potential energy and kinetic energy. You try all these numericals. Okay, children.